Okay. So you guys are gonna fight after we do winners finals,
Kiel, right?
Yes. Okay. So
good luck.
I'm
dude,
at
be ready for the air dash stuff.
Listen, I'm thinking this is real. I spent 2 weeks complaining about Mika V-Skill 2. I think that might work against cross-ups.
Really?
Maybe. And it freezes them in place, so we'll see.
I don't know.
I don't know. We'll find out.
Okay.
BL!
Finna act up. What's up? We finna act up?
We are getting the G on commentary for probably about 30 seconds.
30 whole seconds of me acting up on stream.
One of our lovely community members, they help run the stream. They are learning how to play Street Fighter, working
earlier,
on building a stick,
earlier
hopefully
Ben
eventually
was,
competing at some point.
Mr. Mistopheles was kicking my ass while having a conversation and
that,
not looking at
I
me.
Don't,
just like
I don't remember
the
that happening at all.
You were looking at Tommy and talking to
I've
him.
I've never done such a thing in my life.
And you were just kicking my ass. Like, I was in a corner and I was like, how are you doing this? Please, I'm trying my best.
I don't recall that happening at all, so...
Factual,
you know,
it did.
If there were tapes to check that we could rewatch it, maybe, but I don't
there
remember that happening.
It's fine. So I saw that Kenstar's been playing Mika today.
Yeah.
Which is exciting.
So we actually had about 6 second conversation before he went up there, because as you saw, I got cooked on stream by PL. I didn't know how to deal with Rashid's V-Skill 2.
Yeah.
But Tommy was saying that he hasn't tested it, but he's willing to give the option. So Mika has a V-Skill 2 that's a parry.
Okay.
And as all parries... Well, that's not true. It's a counter, excuse me, not a parry. All counters lose to lows, but he's thinking that her counter might beat cross-ups, so it could potentially be an option against the crazy jumping stuff from Rashid. We'll see.
Okay, yeah. I am intimidated by Rashid players right now. I play Colleen, and she's a very sturdy character.
Right, right.
And then they just jump around, and I
get
real scared.
Yeah, Rashid is a crackhead, as Zygno would say.
Oh, yeah. I know
but
that...
But this will be a good match. This is actually the first time PL's been back in probably about 2 months. Something like that.
Really? Okay.
Already a good showing, as one would expect. He's a very strong fighting game player.
Yeah.
Okay, that's not a good look.
That's rough.
Already put in the corner? Okay, I really like the crouching medium punch. Although that move did get nerfed, it is a good option against ambiguous stuff.
Mm-hmm. I heard a lot of Mika's moves either got nerfed or just haven't been improved upon, which
that's kind of the struggle.
Kinda sad,
She got she did technically get one buff to one of her special moves, but it was kind of superficial.
Yeah.
But and then the other issue is that she got nerfs on some stuff which she didn't really need. But we'll see. Ooh, I really like that sweep.
Because it seems like she's a really solid character.
She's definitely a solid character, but she's...
It's just there's a lot of other characters who are either crackheads or got a bunch of buffs, and now
And beat her in ways that she can't really defend again. What a call out. That was really strong.
Right.
Good reaction. And you know, that might actually be a good option too, because that move compared to traditional uppercuts has really good horizontal range.
Okay.
So if he's trying to fake you out with an early jump in rather than the cross up, he's dead.
I love the booty bash kill.
Oh yeah, of course.
We love to see
Who wouldn't want to die that way?
I know, honestly.
I mean, if we take a poll how we want to go out, I'm pretty sure 9 out of 10 people, give me the peach, but we'll see.
The other one is just crushed between thighs.
Yeah, right.
You know?
Some variation of basically the same thing. Yeah, that crouching medium. He is ready. Okay.
Kenstar got a new Mika keychain for his stick, so maybe that good luck charm is helping him out today.
Right, right.
That must
be
it.
Puts him in the corner. Gotta guess. Mm-hmm. Went for the safe block string. It was a well-spaced crouch heavy punch. He's dead.
Ooh,
oh, not quite. That health buff. That's fine. Take that. He's down a meter. Yep. Gonna use that. That's fine. Oh, no. That's not
just
good.
Just one hit. Just...
Okay.
All right,
the crouch medium punch
again.
Interesting that Mika might... Kind of seems to be the answer to this. Now, part of the issue there, I think, on PL's part was that he was relying on just kind of going crazy. He didn't really want to try and slow down and play in the neutral game very much.
Mm-hmm.
But I wonder if we'll see him try to play a little more composed and patient this round.
Yeah.
And this is first to three.
Okay.
So there will be opportunities for him to adapt. Okay, he is going ham.
It seems like he's really eager
to
jump in.
Oh, that was messed up.
Yeah.
Okay, good heavy mixer. Puts him back in the corner. Ooh, oh, he doesn't confirm off of the stand medium punch. That's fine. That's not a lot of damage. Nice. Good call out. Okay. That's tough against Rashid. Okay. Man, I thought for sure we were going to see EX uppercut. Oh, he catches him trying to whip punish. Okay. Oh, he's dead!
Oh, no. Oh my god.
Okay. How's he going to react?
Oh! Oh my god.
Oh! Okay. Yeah, so that was something I was mentioning last game. I really think that might be the answer to this Rashid V-Skill 2 scenario. Because, again, compared to traditional uppercuts, which typically hit very vertically, her EX wingless airplane has really good horizontal range as well.
Which is really good for catching him when he's
exactly, doing those, yeah, when he's like trying to retreat back and maybe fake you out.
Yeah.
That's really good. I like that Kenstar has picked up on that.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Another one.
And that's a lot of damage and Oki.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine. That's, oh man. And then the side switch too. Okay, he is put in the corner. This is tough. Can't kill. He is going to get into, oh, he doesn't, okay, yep. Cancelled into, yeah. I'm not sure if Mika can get over that with the EX wingless airplane or not.
No, he probably made the guess to see if he was going to go through it.
Right, and then get the cinematic throw to be invincible. Oh, just swinging with heavy punch. That's fine. That's not a bad trade. EX. Nope. Okay, good patience.
Jumps right into that. All right.
That's fine. That's a good trade.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, if I were him, I would honestly call I would call Nadeshko.
Oh,
yo. Oh. Okay, she is safe off of that. That was sick. Ooh, good. No confirm into super though. Okay, so PL ties it up. We did see a new option potentially from Tommy in the V-Skill 2 counter. I wonder if we'll see him try to go for that a little bit more. I think part of the issue there with Tommy letting PL get that run back was he was playing very reactionary.
Yeah.
And trying to kind of rest back on his haunches poised, hoping for PL to make some of the same mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
And he wasn't engaging as much in the neutral with buttons. So I would like to see him try and throw out like that stand medium kick a little bit more, crouching light kick. Make him respect your space more rather than just trying to catch him jumping
in. Tommy's definitely not putting as much pressure.
Yeah.
Which is, I think, a mistake, especially because Rashid is so good at just doing those constant jump-ins, those constant just, like, I don't know how to explain.
No, I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
It's easy for, oh, that was really tricky.
Oh, wow.
Okay, gonna try and make him guess.
Yeah. Especially with how
PL
plays
okay,
Rashid,
at least
you really
gonna
have
confirm
to
off of it.
Be aggressive rather than just stay back, or else you're never gonna get anything in.
He's playing pretty okay. Good block. That's minus seven. Okay. Oh no. Yeah, it doesn't work without EX. Okay. He can kill. Oh, what a mix-up.
Oh wow.
Okay. He went for the mix-up, which is interesting. It did save a meter. He could have killed with another Crouch Fierce into EX Peach,
mm-hmm.
but he chose to save the meter play a little riskier, which is fine. That look at what's given him already. He's got a 60% life
right
lead, or 40%, excuse me.
Yeah.
Got him in the corner. Hold that, yep. Okay, no Oki. Nice, good call. He's so ready.
I feel like he can hear us, because now he's starting to play more aggressively.
There's a good chance.
Yeah.
That's fine. Block it out. Ooh, I really like that. That's fine. Hold that. Yep. He knew it was his turn. He took the turn back after the crush pierce. I like it. He's dead.
No.
He's okay. That's fine. You've got a million life to give. Yep.
No,
call out Rashid. Smart. Or call out Nadeshko. That was checkmate.
Nice.
Okay. We're seeing... Again, you know, despite some of the ways that PL did adapt, we are seeing Tommy stick to basically his same game plan and just make slight tweaks to play the way that he's most comfortable with so that he's not losing. And I'm really liking it, to be honest.
I wish that Tommy was better at, like, explaining these types of things to newer players, because sometimes he has
That's why you've got me.
Yeah, nice. Because he does have a lot of really good critical sense.
Of course.
And
of
he's,
course.
Like, obviously one of the better players that we have here.
Yeah,
it's just,
for sure.
I don't know how to learn from just watching him
right,
play.
Right.
That's fine. Let him use the meter. Yep, he calls it out, and now he gets a mix-up. Okay, confirm. Okay, this is going to be good damage. He's going to go for a mix-up here.
Ooh,
yes, that's tricky.
Ooh.
He's dead. He's dead.
Wow.
Yep, and he gets to save his meter. Okay, he's going into this with so much momentum. He's one round away. He's basically tied up on meter, and he's really shut down PL's wacky air approach. That's fine. That doesn't really even hurt that much. Mika is such a volatile character that she can turn this around in two guesses. That's fine, he got out of there. Smart. Good awareness. Okay, yep, he's waiting for the jump. Smart. Oh, he didn't confirm it. But he catches him trying to whiff punish. Falling asleep. Okay. Yep, he's dead. He can't kill. He cannot kill. Okay, one guess away. Okay, back throw. Okay, this is a tricky situation.
Ooh.
Oh, okay, but that's actually not the worst case scenario. Oh, that was tricky. He was respecting it. To be honest, if I were him, I think I would have gone for the throw tech because his options there were either EX Tornado, which would have killed him, or he could have chipped him out with Super. So either way, if he just held that, he was potentially going to die.
Yeah.
So why not try and throw tech to potentially save that option, which blocking wouldn't be.
Yeah. Tommy's Mika almost intimidates me more than his birdie, because he does a bunch of goofy, like,
right.
dumb bullshit with birdie,
yeah.
but the way that he plays Mika is very...
Very smart,
very
calculated.
Very clean,
mm-hmm.
very crisp, and it's
mm-hmm.
almost worse, I think. Yeah.
Ooh, okay. I think that was a misinput. Oh, this... Okay, good. Oh, man, that side switch is deadly. Oh, I was definitely expecting the command grab. Okay. Oh, he called it
wow.
out. Okay. No wake up super. I was expecting it. Okay, good blocks. Okay, he's dead.
Wow.
Yep.
Nice. Right out of it.
Okay. Nice. That was a really great showing from Tommy, and he has to feel good about doing that with Mika.
Oh,
he
yeah.
has to. His
oh,
favorite
yeah.
character.
Mika isn't good. He said Mika isn't good.